Hey everybody, Kevin Elliott here with Home Dabbler. It is summertime, it is hot outside, and that means you are probably watering the living heck out of your grass right now to keep it healthy and green and alive, right? I get a lot of questions on how to water your grass properly. How long should I water? How often should I water? What time of day should I water? And so I would like to give you a few tips on how to do just that. When I was managing professional properties, when I was doing lots of big properties and also residential, I found that people were almost always doing this incorrectly. They were just watering their grass the wrong way. And I think that's because there are some myths out there about what your grass actually needs and the rules that it wants to live by. So I'd like to dispel those myths and give you a few basic pointers that will make you and your grass much happier. The first thing that I find, the first mistake that people make, is they water their grass way too often. You're watering your grass way too often. I know people here where I live that water every single day in the growing season. That is a mistake. Your grass does not need to be watered every single day. So think of it like this. You have plants out there in nature, and your grass is no different. How do those plants get water? Rainfall, right? They get water when it rains. Well, think about the natural water cycle, the rain cycle where you live. So unless you live in Bali or the tropics or something, it's not raining every single day. Your plants don't expect to be watered every single day. They want to live by the natural rhythms of nature. So think of it like this. You'll have a period of drought, of dry weather, and then you'll have a front come through, and that rain will come and drop a lot of water on your landscape all at one time. So it may last 45 minutes, an hour, a few hours, maybe a day. And then it goes away for a while, and you have this period of drought. That's the natural rhythm. And so all plants expect to have periods of water and periods of drought. Well, your grass is no different. Don't make special rules just for your grass. Your grass expects to be watered in a certain period and then have drought in between. So instead of watering like every day or every other day, try like twice a week. Try less often. And here's a way you can know when your grass needs water. It will actually tell you. Did you know that? Your grass will tell you when it actually needs water, and you shouldn't water it until it tells you that it needs it. So here's what we call the step test. The step test. So you walk into your yard, and if you step on your grass, and when you remove your foot, if that grass starts to come back up like this, it springs back, your grass does not need water. And I don't care how long it's been in between waterings. If you stand on the grass and it comes back up, even slowly, it does not need water. So the step test is if you step on your grass, and when you remove your foot, that grass just stays flat, it will not come back, that's when you water. Okay? So try that. Now, it's gonna freak you out the first time you do this. You're gonna go out in your yard, it's gonna look dry. You know how it looks, it gets dull, it gets dry. That's not a bad thing. Remember, plants in nature are used to periods of drought. You should train your grass likewise. So stand on it. When you see that it's not coming back up, then water it deep, which is the second tip, is that people should water less often, but when you do water, you should water much more at one time. Think of that rainstorm. The rain's going to come in, it's just going to soak and soak and soak, and then it's going to go away. People do the opposite. They water it much more frequently, and they'll water just a little bit. Well, that hurts your grass, because what's going to happen is your grass is not going to dig deep feeder roots. It's just going to sit on the surface like this, because it knows that in less than 24 hours it's going to get another little sprinkle. Well, that causes problems, because then your roots are right on the top where the sun can hit them and burn them. Just like that. So the first time something goes wrong, your grass is not tough at all. It's not resilient, and it's going to struggle. The other thing is, if you have water all the time on your grass, if you're watering every day, you are breeding fungus, you are breeding bugs, and those other things that cause problems in your grass. So when you do water, water much deeper. So say instead of a 15-minute or 20-minute cycle, run it for 45 minutes to an hour, but only do it when your grass actually tells you that it needs water, and it will be in much more rhythm with nature. You will train your grass to be more resilient, okay? So the next thing is, what time of day should I water? Okay, so a lot of people water in the middle of the night, And some people water in the middle of the day or in the morning when the sun after the sun comes up. The sweet spot for watering your grass is just before sunrise. Okay? So you want to time it. So whenever the sunrise is where you are, you want your grass to finish watering just about 20, 30 minutes before sunrise. And the reason being is if you say turn the sprinklers on when you go to bed at night, okay, and they water in the middle of the night, yes, the water is going to soak all the way down, and that's fine. It's going to work. But remember, the blades of that grass, the leaves, are going to be wet all night long. And that's just, you're just begging for fungus when you do that. You're also begging for bugs when you do that. So don't water in the middle of the night. The other thing is don't water after the sun comes up, because then the heat is going to evaporate that water before it can really soak down deep into those roots. So you want to time it so the water finishes it about 30 minutes before the sun comes up. So say in your yard, you have 3 irrigation zones. And those of you who have a big enough yard, you know irrigation zones. So if the sun comes up at 6 o'clock in the morning where you live and you have 3 zones, start watering about 3 o'clock in the morning. Okay, so that first zone's going to go about 45 minutes. Second zone kicks on, 45 minutes. Third zone kicks on, finishes about 30 minutes before the sun comes up. It gives time for the water to soak in. Then the sun comes up and dries the leaves. Now you have wet roots and dry leaves. That's healthy grass. So here are the tips. Water less often. Use the step test. Let the grass tell you and build tough grass. The second thing is when you do water, water more deeply. Water longer, but less frequently. Third, let your grass finish watering just before sunrise. And that will make for happy, tough, good, green grass. Thanks.